In the previous videos, we overcame several challenges to get our product on its way to us. Now the ship is at sea. The sea route is the same as it always has been. Surely not much can happen at this level that will slow us down. Well, yes and no. If there's a COVID outbreak on the ship, obviously the ship will not be allowed into most ports until the crew has cleared whatever the federal protocol is for that country. But even if there is no outbreak, most countries have some measures in place that slow down the process. Shipping lanes are also strained to the max right now, with every major shipping company pushing as hard as they can to get us caught up on the backlog of products. 100% of capable shipping vessels are being used. No freight company has backup boats waiting to replace the ones that are running. This means that any breakdowns, such as storm damage, engine problems, crew sickness, hull issues, etc., result in the ship simply sitting in one place until the breakdown has been taken care of or repaired. The increased strain on shipping lanes was perfectly illustrated not too long ago when an ocean liner got stuck in the Suez Canal. Literally, a big boat ended up crooked in the Suez Canal, and commercial shipping was backed up for a week and a half while people tried to figure out how to get the boat out. These kinds of things can happen at the best of times, but with so much uncertainty already in play, these small hiccups have a multiplying effect. Although the travel time through the open sea is relatively unaffected by the current situation, any travel through choke points like the Suez or Panama Canal have been slowed down significantly as more ships are trying to get through the same small channel. But the biggest slowdown has yet to affect our ship. Although we've traveled halfway around the world, the biggest slowdown is waiting for us at the end of our transoceanic journey. Just as we think we're set to arrive at port, our ship sees a line of ships. As it turns out, there's nowhere for us to park. At the time this video was made, coastal ports were seeing backups of up to 20 ships. Imagine you're shopping for groceries, but the only checkout line has 20 people in it and everybody's cart is piled over the top. Now, multiply that by a giant ocean vessel, and you'll have an idea of how our boat crew feels as they pull up over the horizon. But once we get into port, at least we'll have our flooring available, right? Well, there's a problem. In the next video, we'll take a look at issues that are facing our coastal ports.
Horizon Forest Products, the hardwood experts.